The project started really organically with the box of found objects, which are all things that I collected, and started seeing as these amulets and little divinatory objects. I thought, what if I shared these with people and they could ask questions to this box that I can actually wear on my body with straps and it's open? And I created a series of dice that correspond to the objects. And through those archetypes, I created this divination system to share with people. So they roll two sets of dice, which give them a combination of two of these archetypes. And then that's how the cards on the wall correspond to the reading portion. We'll find their card and have a conversation based on something that they're thinking about in their life or a question they might have. And based on those conversations, that leads into these painted tapestries where these strangers that I had these intimate conversations with became kind of the embodiments of each of these cards. And at the end of the reading, which is really just a conversation, they're invited to be part of this painted portrait project. And so I took their photo on the street, and then I would put them into these sort of fantastical, dreamlike compositions with the card visible in each of the frames. Once the painting is complete, I cut it all apart and I cut out all of the shapes and all of the rocks and all of the clouds, and I collage in different fabrics that I've found during the process of painting that piece. Sometimes they're my own clothes. And there are a lot of single-use plastics also that you'll see in the cards as well, because I really like the idea of creating these kind of dreamlike, fleeting moments that are made from really common materials that we're handling all the time and maybe not seeing the potential in because it's so disposable. I like the history of sewing and quilting. It feels very like it's grounded in community and bringing many things to create a whole, and also the spontaneity of bringing all these materials together and kind of committing to this is now like the skin of this landscape. So here we are at my studio at the Rockport Center for the Arts. And as you can see, I've got a lot of wall space. What I really like about residencies is having the time and the space and the support to really invest in a body of work that can be in process. This is really nice that I get to see everything come full circle and have a complete exhibition while having a studio downstairs where I can kind of, you know, experiment with the ceramics studio, continue painting for this project, but allow new ideas and new works to bloom. This project is definitely born out of being in residence because I wanted to make this vast world that could collapse into a box. So the cards and the objects, they're all very portable, very collapsible, and I can share them, you know, I can unfurl them and share them very easily in a sort of nomadic lifestyle. But I would say the through line between all of my projects is finding the possibility in the things we leave behind and creating these narrative storylines for the mundane and the everyday, and kind of finding the magical experience of every day. I like that each new person who sees the project kind of brings in their own storytelling.